Hello again, YouTube. Enzo back bringing you another video review, and today we are going to be taking a look at some legend class figures from the Transformers Cybertron line. So we have Jetfire and Starscream. These are, by doubt, my favourite legends figures of all time. No matter what legends series you like, the Cybertron series was my absolute favourite, and I adored Starscream and I adored Jetfire. But my absolute all time favourite legends class wise is Starscream, and I'll tell you a bit more about that when we get into the review. Just got the Infinitor in the back there, just to show you scale-wise how big they are. They're still quite a little bit too big to fit in scale-wise, but they're not too bad. And I'll just bring Jazz in, so you can see how they stack up. And obviously we'll do another one when we do the transformation. So I'll just put Jazz in the back there now. So we'll get on to, let's do Jetfire first. So Jetfire is like a Hercules kind of style jet, you know, built for carrying cargo, and he's quite big and beefy. And I actually had the Voyager size toy of this, and he was big. And to be honest with you, the transformation is exactly the same. You know, being Legends class, you know, he's got molding detail, but no wheels, and the fists are visible, but the nice silver detail there with the Autobot insignia. And it is a really, really good, solid jet mod. Really is cool. And transformation could be simpler. It's exactly the same as the Voyager one. So what I do is I just go behind here, flip up the tail fin like that, pull down his legs like that, pull that section down and rotate the waist around, make sure it's facing the right way. There we go. Nose cone down, push it down so it tabs that little notch there, tabs into that like so. And even after many years of owning these figures, these joints are really still stiff, which is good. And I just tab that in there like that. Bring down the arms like that. And then if you've got a good long nail, you can get in there. And you can, come on Jetfire, you can pull his head out like that. And there we have Cybertron Legends Jetfire. And like I said, the transformation is exactly the same as the Voyager figure, except that you would be able to slide these arms forward and the fists would pop out. But apart from that, that's it. I mean, you can't complain. It's a Legends figure and it's cool. It's absolutely cool. A lot of people are like, oh, he's got a big hole there. He's a Legends. The Voyager size was exactly the same. Transformation was exactly the same. You had a massive gaping hole there as well. So you can't beat the figure for that. And then there's still the original slot for the Cyber Planet key, which would pop in there. And all it was basically was lights and sounds. That would pop out. And he's got guns in his back. And that's it. So, but again, a really cool little figure. For posability, head doesn't go anywhere. Wings are on hinges, so you can angle them up and down whichever way you want. Arms going out for transformation. And they bend at the elbow. He does have waist articulation because it's on a swivel. Hips are on a ball joint. Knees are on a ball joint. Pardon me. So you get some really good poses out this figure, and I just think he's brilliant. Now, so that's enough for Jetfire. Now, my absolute favourite figure of all time is Starscream. Now, this is based on the War Within mould, and I actually had the deluxe figure of this, and I also had the Supreme figure. And my God, he was absolutely gigantic. He was massive. Transformation from this one to Voyager to Super was exactly the same. So all you're going to do is I just put the arms up like that, grab hold of the leg, pull it down, rotate it at the hip, swivel it around, push the foot out, same in this time, just pull the leg out, rotate it around, flip it like that. I then just move the shoulders forward, so I've got enough room to swivel the backpack around, and then pull the arms down like that, flip the backpack down, and there you have Starscream in his robot mode. And you can see from the paint has worn over time, especially on this side, because that's how much I've played with this figure. It's absolutely fantastic. I love Little Legends Class Starscream. He is great. Absolutely great. Head can swivel back and forth, but because of the massive missile pods and things he's got there, difficult to move. Arms are on ball joints, so you can move them all over the place there. Fists, nothing much there, just elbow joint which goes backwards just due for transformation. There is no waist joint, unfortunately, but the hips are on ball joints and the knees are on ball joints, and you've got a little bit of foot articulation there. And I just think he's cool. And what I find really good about this figure is he's retained his gimmicks from the Deluxe and the... What's happening? A little bit of plastic flaking away there. Like I said, he's old now. Yeah, he retains his gimmicks from the Deluxe and the Supreme. So if I just go behind here, you'll see he has the little flip-out sword, which is cool. Let me just make sure I got enough light on here now, which is cool. And then on the other side there, you just flip it out there, he's got his cannon. Someone's commented and said, oh, this is the Matrix cannon. Yeah, well, you know, whatever. It's a cannon nonetheless. And he's very nicely detailed. The plastic is cool. The plastic quality is great. It's lasted a long time. He's a bit dusty because I've only just found him. He's been in storage. I was worried that the wife had thrown him out because we've had a bit of a purge in the house, a bit of a clean, and I wasn't sure what she's thrown and what she's not thrown. And I was like, I was so chuffed when I found these. I have more Legends Cybertron figures to review, and they'll be coming up over the next couple of videos. But again, absolutely cool. So the so he's got his blasters there as normal, but you know, wow, flips out a massive cannon. Talk about bringing a knife to a gunfight. This figure's got both. Absolutely brilliant. I don't know if you can get these figures anymore. You could probably find them on eBay or something like that, but I would highly recommend if you can get a Legends class figure, especially from the Cybertron line, you won't be disappointed. And they're just about comes up to Jazz's waist there, a little bit under there, so you know what you're getting. And I just think they're absolutely cool. You can get them as individual packs, or you can get them as a pack of four. I believe you can get Starscream, Jetfire, Megatron and Optimus Prime in a four pack, and they vary, and every single one is available. And yeah, Starscream is by all doubts my favourite. He was the favourite in the show, without a doubt, because the way he'd take on Primus, I mean, he didn't give a monkeys. I mean, Starscream would take on anyone. And fair play, in some situations, he got his ass kicked. But fair play to him, he always bounced back, and he kicked ass. Absolutely fantastic. And they do look good together. They transform, the transformations are not complicated, but they're quite satisfying. Their robot modes are okay. Starscream and Jetfire, their vehicle modes are phenomenal. I love their vehicle modes. I love both their jet modes. Really, really cool figures. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, if you can get your hands on one, I highly recommend you pick these up. These are great for, well, I wouldn't say young children, maybe 5 and up. My 5-year-old son absolutely adores these figures. He can't stop playing with them. Only trouble is, he likes to pull all the ball joints apart. And there's a few figures, there's a few figures that he's managed to pull apart, and we've lost them. So I'm going to have to go on the hunt now and see if I can find some more. But yes, there we are. If you can get them, please get them. Please stay tuned, because I have more Transformers, Cybertron Legends, class figures, reviews coming up. I've also had an update from TF Source. So the upgrade kit for Transformers Combiner Wars Ultra Magnus on its way, and the Beelzebub kit for Optimus Prime is on the way. And I also have two other items, which I'm not going to say too much about. I'm going to surprise you, so stay tuned. And I'm up to 15 subscribers. A couple more people subscribed over the weekend. So if that was you, diolch yn fawr. Thank you very much. I don't mind if I've got 5, 10, 15, 150. I don't care. If you enjoy these videos, I enjoy making them. And I'm gonna carry on making them. So if you like it, leave a comment. Leave me a thumbs up. Let me know what you're liking. And if you have any sort of ideas, if it's something that you would like me to review, let me know. I've got quite a large collection. Let me know. I'll see what I can do for you. So again, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Diolch yn fawr. And I shall see you next time. Thank you. Ta-ra.